Hello, I'm Dr. Beth Colby and work as a psychiatrist in London. Tardive dyskinesia is a movement disorder caused by medication. Patients who are on antipsychotic medication for months or years may develop tardive dyskinesia. The antipsychotic medication may have been prescribed for schizophrenia, bipolar affective disorder, or psychotic depression. Tardive dyskinesia may also be caused by some antidepressants, lithium, and medication for epilepsy or nausea and vomiting. Symptoms of tardive dyskinesia develop gradually over time and may be difficult to diagnose and distinguish from other movement disorders. Tardive dyskinesia causes great discomfort and embarrassment and interferes with everyday tasks. Tardive dyskinesia mainly affects the face. People with tardive dyskinesia have involuntary, repetitive, irregular movements of the face and or the body. These include blinking, lip smacking, chewing movements, grimacing, making noises, movement of the hips, tapping of the feet, movements of the torso or neck, unusual facial expression, and movements of the jaw, nose and mouth. These movements may continue even if medication is discontinued or changed. Some movements are jerky, but others are more smooth, such as writhing movements. Some are due to muscle spasms, such as grunting noises, and these muscle spasms may affect somebody's breathing or swallowing. Tardive dyskinesia may also cause an unusual gait or changes in posture. Some people with schizophrenia move their arms and legs around a lot or are restless. And this can occur prior to taking antipsychotic medication. When diagnosing tardive dyskinesia, other causes of movement disorder should be excluded. These include Huntington's chorea, Parkinson's disease, and Tourette syndrome. First generation or typical antipsychotics are more likely to cause tardive dyskinesia than second generation or atypical antipsychotics. Tardive dyskinesia is thought to be caused by irregular dopamine signalling in the part of the brain that controls movement. Typical antipsychotics antagonise or block the dopamine receptors and bind more strongly to the receptors than atypical. This may be why tardive dyskinesia is more likely with typical antipsychotics. Also, second generation antipsychotics block serotonin receptors, and this is thought to reduce the risk of tardive dyskinesia. 20% of patients on typical antipsychotics develop tardive dyskinesia. Risk factors for tardive dyskinesia include women, especially postmenopausal women, older age, African heritage, duration of exposure and dose of antipsychotic, a patient who already has extrapyramidal side effects from the antipsychotic medication, long-term use of anticholinergic drugs, such as prasiclidine, used to treat extrapyramidal side effects, people with learning disability or brain injury, people who use drugs or alcohol, including smoking tobacco, and people with diabetes. Treatments tried for tardive dyskinesia include stopping the antipsychotic medication, switching from a first generation to a second generation antipsychotic, switching over to clozapine, as this antipsychotic is significantly less likely to cause tardive dyskinesia than other antipsychotics, and coming off anticholinergic drugs. These treatments may prevent the progression of the disorder. However, there is little evidence that these actually stop the symptoms of tardive dyskinesia. People may develop tardive dyskinesia even after discontinuing antipsychotic medication.